Hello party people, this is Michele Lamberti speaking. Welcome to the new game of the day, another Sicilian. This is a game played by Cicotea against Jansa. It was played in Germany in 1963. Both players are unknown to me. I just thought that you should see this this game. Very beautiful attacking game. I think the games that I show you here are games that you really should know by heart. I mean, the players are not always known, the games are not always known, but these are important games if you play this kind of openings. And I would also think that they are good fun. Okay, Cicotea with black started e4. We see the knight of defense here with black, and in the last game black played white played bishop to g4 g5, and here bishop to c4 is another main move here, another way to attack the knight off. Okay, we see the standard moves, and here white plays queen to f3, ideas f4, f5, castling short, and then taking the king position. And Cicotea was an attacking player. You can see it here. He wastes no time, and he goes for g4, immediately attacking the king. White exchanged the bishop, the knight on c6. And as I said, he was a very aggressive player. He goes immediately for g5. And okay, the position is about equal. I mean, the strategy is clear for white. He will castle along, put his rooks here on g and h, and then just push the pawns. And the strategy for black is also clear. He wants to attack on the king side. Now he wants to play rook to b8 and rook to c8, and then here rang down. He played c5, a better move would have been d5, but okay. White castles on, and black here plays c4 with the idea of pushing the bishop on a square that is not so good. Because at the end of the day, you may ask, okay, where is this bishop going? But white has a cute idea. He exchanges. So he basically exchanges his good piece, a good minor piece, and gives up as the bishop pair. But white has this idea. And okay, you don't really want to take here, because then there's always a risk of f6 and opening up here. So he played, black played, Jansa played queen to b7. The idea is here to gunning down and threatening b2. He thought that this would be sufficient. But Cicotea white just ignores it and plays f6. And okay, let's see what happens if black just takes. This may look good, but this attack is going basically nowhere. Because after this move here, rook to b1, what do you do with black? It's a complete over. So so you cannot really take on b2. So black played is bishop to d8. This is a good move. I mean, the position is still in equilibrium. It's still equal. So no damage has been done. And okay, white plays b3, ab3. And okay, this is now bishop to a5. And this is a very good looking move. You may ask, hey, what do you do here? You know, it's, if the rook comes over here to c8, then queen b3 is threatened. Well, what do you do here? And white just ignored all the threats. And black really played rook to c8. And at first you may ask here, well, this is over for white. But from now on, white just always threatens mate. And black has no time for his threats. Basically, white is coming first, and this is another typical situation in those kind of very sharp lines. The player that gets first, that has one tip or more, just wins. And this is here the problem for Black Cat. White always plays with mating threats. And you may ask, okay, well, what now? I mean, here on F7, everything is covered, this is like a strong looking position. What do you do? Yeah, you play G6, and this is what Black just missed. The problem is that you are now in big, big trouble. If you take, yeah, then let's see what the engine wants. If you take, you can, yeah, just basically here take here, and this is over. This is like mate. So after G6, let's look at Black played H3 G6, which is a good move. Let's look at FG6. Then basically you have this cute move. And the idea behind this is really to play the queen to F8, believe it or not, because although you have two pieces here protecting F8, and the king, it's not enough, because white is attacking 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces. So you have one piece missing. Now you can get one piece more with queen to e8, e7, but then you can take. And the problem is that even after this move, after the big exchange, you end up with one piece more. And this is a problem here for Black in this variation, and he basically loses one piece. But you had to see this before you played all those moves. So basically, White here was able to look 10, 12, 40 moves into the future. And okay, this is one reason why the Sicilian is not for the faint-hearted, and you have to be very, very strong when it comes to calculations. Okay, let's look at the actual game here. Black played bishop pawn capturing on g6. And what is the idea now? Well, you play again with mating threats. You play queen to h3. So Black has no time to capture here. Black has to react. And yeah, you infiltrate the position. And now again, you may ask, okay, but what do you do here? It's what is the idea? You have to do something, otherwise you lose. And another mating threat. Now we are coming from the center, and we are threatening mate on h8. e5 again. What do you do? It seems that everything is blocked. What is what can you do? Well, you prepare another mate. You play rook to d3. If you capture, then the rook goes to h3, and this will be mate. So he has to defend, and okay, make a good move, making it impossible to play the rook to h3. Okay, now it's Black, it's white choice. Well, what do you do? What can you do? Yeah, he just plays his bishop, his knight to d5. Another mating threat, f6 and e7, and okay, Black defends again. It's this is the reason why I choose this game. It's very funny because White always threatens mate, and Black always comes up with a defense. And you may think this may go on forever, but it doesn't. And here, White sacrificed his rook, another mating threat. Black has to take. White plays queen to h7. Black goes to f8, basically the only move. And here White took with g6. And okay, as you can see, the king is completely weak. And you have, I mean, you can take it, but then the rook comes, and you have to defend against it. You have no time for grabbing material. And now the last piece comes into the attack. Queen h6 was played. King goes to d8. e8. Check on h8. And okay, here why Black resigned, because he really made it. Let's look at the mate. This is mate. So this was a fantastic game. An attack worthy of Tal, basically. Again, I wanted to show you this because as a warning, and as a I just liked how white basically for 10-12 moves works with mating threats, and black is not able to execute his idea. I mean, this is like completely, if white would have made some stupid move, black just wins. But he always works with mating threats, and his attack and his threats, they do not get weaker, and okay. Thank you very much, bye bye.